Congratulations! Your new Omnicord System 2 from the Suzuki Corporation is about to open up to you the exciting world of the music computer. Take your instrument and place it on the table in front of you. At first, it may appear a little complicated, but as we go through the sections and the buttons one at a time, you will quickly see how easy it is to make beautiful music the very first time you try. Think of your Omnicord as two different instruments in one, because it actually has two different ways to make music. First of all, it's an accompanying instrument. That is, it can accompany you or others by providing the chords and rhythm background to the melody line that you or others provide by singing or humming. Secondly, your new Omnicord can also be played as a melodic instrument. That is, you can play the melody as well as the chords and rhythm. Let's start now by learning how you can use the Omnicord to play chords and rhythm and accompany yourself as you sing or hum along. As you look at your Omnicord, notice how it is divided into six different sections. At the upper left is the master control section. Immediately under the master control section is the level mode section. The next section down is the rhythm section. The chord memory interface section is in the lower left-hand corner. The main body of the instrument contains the major, minor, and seventh chord buttons, and immediately to its right is the strum plate or sonic strings section. The small strum plate in the upper right-hand corner of this section stops the music when you push it gently with your finger. You will use this whenever you come to the end of a song. Now, if you have plugged in your adapter to the power source, or if you have put in your batteries, we're ready to start. Now, why don't you turn on your instrument by pushing down the red button in the master control section? The small red light will glow as you turn on the instrument. Next, turn that master volume to the right or to about the 1 o'clock position. Next, look at the level mode section. Turn the smaller inner voice volume knob to the 3 o'clock position and the larger outer voice volume knob to the 12 o'clock position. Next, turn the sustain button all the way to the right, or clockwise. Now look at the rhythm section immediately below. To begin with, we want all the rhythm buttons to be in the off or up position. If any of the rhythm buttons are down or in the on position, they can be turned off by simply pushing partway down on any other rhythm button until you see the depressed button snap to the up position. Now let up on the button you are pushing, and all the rhythm buttons should be in the up position. Now notice the black chord-only button in the same section. This button must be depressed. If it's not depressed, the chord will sound continuously, much like an organ sound. Now be sure the playback record button in the chord memory interface section is depressed. If this button is left in the up position, all rhythm and chord sounds will stop the moment you take your finger off the chord button. The instrument is now ready to play chords and the strum plate. With a finger on your left hand, any finger, just push the C major chord on the top line. For the time, keep your finger right on the C major chord. Now with your right hand, strum the strum plate from the bottom clear to the top. It should sound like this. Do this several times to get the feel of the Omnicord. Now with your left hand again, push down and hold the G seventh chord in the bottom row of the chords, and again strum the strum plate. For a few moments now, try strumming the C chord three times, then the G7 chord three times, back and forth, like this. Why don't you stop your recorder right here and practice these two chords until the move back and forth becomes very smooth and rhythmical. Now, let's try these chords with a rhythm. Look at your level mode section. The inside knob farthest to the right is your chords knob. Turn this knob clear to the right or clockwise. In the rhythm section, just below the level mode section, set the tempo knob to about 10 o'clock. We're now going to start with a waltz rhythm. So we will push the blue button in the rhythm section down so we can get the bottom row of rhythms. This is where the waltz rhythm is located, and we want it to sound for us. Now, let's push the gray button down that is just above the word waltz, and push the C chord. You should hear this. Now we're going to try strumming to this rhythm like this. This effect is made by strumming on the first beat and tapping your fingers on the strum plate on the second and third beats. Why don't you stop your recorder here and try changing the chord buttons and play C for three measures, then G7 for three measures, then back to C and G7 again, like this. If you want to try your instrument, try to keep it as smooth as possible. So if you'll stop your recorder here and try this for a few moments. Now we're ready to play a song. Let's start with a song called Blow the Man Down, found on page 11 in the Just for Kids songbook. The whole song has only two chords that we have been practicing, going back and forth with. Try strumming along with the chords as you hum, like this. Why don't you try this song now for yourself and practice this for a few minutes. Congratulations again. You now have your first song that you can play with your new Omnichord. Now let's try another one. We'll leave your master control volume at about 1 o'clock and your Sonic Strings voice buttons at 3 o'clock for the inner button and 12 o'clock for the outer button. Keep the sustain button all the way to the right, and as also the inner chords button in the same section. We're going to play this next song in a march rhythm. So the blue button remains down, and depress the gray march button in the rhythm section. Now we're ready. In your large Omnichord spoken here songbook on page 169 is the song, This Land is Your Land. Let's look at it for a moment. You'll quickly notice the chords above the staff or the melody line are all either C, G, D7, or G7. Look at these four chords on your instrument. Do you see where they're located? Now, as you look back at your book, you will notice the first chord doesn't sound until the second measure. And it's a C chord. The first three notes of the song are the same chord as the last note of the song. You'll see that that chord is a G7. So the first three notes will harmonize with that G7 chord. If you want to, take a pencil and write G7 above the first measure at the beginning of the song. Go ahead and do so, because that's the chord we'll start with. So let's go ahead and push that G7 chord, and it'll sound like this. Notice the beat. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Play it like this. Strum, 2, 3, 4. Strum, tap, tap, tap. Now, why don't you stop your recorder and practice this on your Omnichord for a moment. The strum, tap, tap, tap. Good. Now we're ready. I'm going to play the chords for you first while you watch the chord buttons, and I'll try to name the chord changes for you. We'll start with a G7, then a C. This land is your land. This land is my land. From California to the New York Island, from the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream waters, this land was made for you and me. G7 to a C. This land, and back to a G, then down to a D7, do, 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 back to G, do, G7, do, 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 C, do, 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 G. G, then a C and a G. Now, if you were following along in the book, you could see these chords. And so why don't you stop your instrument again, your recorder here, and go back to the beginning of this song with your book, and it's your turn. Why don't you try to practice playing this song until the changes become smooth? Well, congratulations are in order again. You're now ready to move on to more and more songs. However, before you do, there are a few more things you should know about your new Omnichord. First of all, not every song is made up of just major, minor, and seventh chords. There are other modern so-called colored chords that you can play with your new Omnichord. One of these is the diminished chord. This can be played by depressing the major and minor chords simultaneously. Let's try the C diminished chord on your instrument and try listening to the difference in this way. First, eliminate all the rhythms. Next, push the chord only button so that it goes into the up position. This is the black button in the rhythm section. Now push the C major button. It sounds like this. Now push both the major and minor buttons to produce a diminished chord. It'll sound like this. The C, C diminished. Do you hear the difference from the C, C diminished? Now let's try the C augmented chord by pushing the C major, C minor, and C seventh chords simultaneously, like this. This is called a C augmented. Now we can also make a C major seventh chord by pushing the C major and C seventh together, like this. This is your C major seventh. We can also make a C minor seventh by pushing the C minor and the seventh C seventh chords together like this. So now we can make all of the following chords with just the C. With C major, C minor, C seventh, C diminished, C augmented, C major seventh, and C minor seventh. Now I'd like to have you turn off your recorder again for a minute and try all these combinations, your omnichords, the major, minor, seventh, diminished, augmented, major seventh, and minor seventh, and try it in different keys, like perhaps the G, the F, the B flat. Listen for the changes. There are several different things you can do with your instrument to add interest to your music. One thing you can do is to make the instrument sound like a piano, by simply turning the sustain button back to around 12 o'clock and depressing your chord only button again. Now, instead of sounding like this, when we turn our sustain back to 12 o'clock, it sounds like a piano. By adding a swing rhythm at between 1 and 2 o'clock and then tapping the strum plate with the three fingers at a time to that rhythm, you can get the honky-tonk piano sound. Let's try it. We turn our sustain button clear back to about 12 o'clock. We've got our tempo button that we've turned up to about 1:30 or 2 o'clock. And let's put on a swing beat by pushing the blue button down. And our swing beat down, pushing the C button and tapping our fingers. And so on. Why don't you stop your recorder again and try the honky-tonk piano effect on your omnichord? Another interesting sound you can get with your omnichord is the sound of a steel guitar. This sound starts flat and then slurs up to the correct pitch. It's often associated with Hawaiian or island music. You can make this sound on your omnichord by pushing both the, as an example, the E flat major and the E major chord simultaneously, and then raising the E flat finger as you strum upward on the strum plate. To start with, put your sustain button all the way again to the right. Eliminate any beats or rhythms. And now we want to push both the E-flat and the E buttons. We can do this with one hand by using your little finger on the E-flat and your pointer finger on the E. And then when we strum, it should sound like this. We can move to the A-flat and A, push both down, and then raise the finger on the A-flat as we strum upward, and it will sound like this. Now try the B flat and B like this. And back to your E flat and E. And you have the sound of a steel guitar. Again, why don't you stop your recorder here and try to get the steel guitar sound for a moment. You can also make your omnichord sound like a large organ with a harp accompaniment. This is done by turning off all the rhythms, putting the chord-only button in the up position, and now the sustain button in the far right position. We can tone down the organ sound by turning the inner chords button in the level mode section, that's the button farthest to the right, and the inner button, turn it to about 3 o'clock. This will tone down the organ sound and make it not quite as loud. We can also add a little vibrato to our harp sound now by turning the larger outside voice button to 3 o'clock, the same as the inside button. Now we'll try the organ sound by pushing first a B flat chord, then a G minor chord, then C minor, then F7, and back to B flat again. Now let's repeat this pattern while we strum, tap, and draw circles with your fingers on the strum plate, much like this. As you practice this, try to see if you can imagine a large organ and try to make it sound like a harp that's playing along with it in accompaniment. Why don't you stop again your recorder right here and practice with the organ and harp sounds. Before we move into the chord memory interface section, there is one more feature on your new Omnichord you should know about. That's the transpose feature. There will be times when you go to play and sing along with a song that's written in a key that's just too high or too low for your voice. If this happens, this is what you do. If you look at the seventh chords on your Omnichord, notice that F7, C7, and G7 have small triangular designs on the keys. When we push all three buttons simultaneously, a C chord will sound like this. Now, if the song is too high for your voice, try lowering this chord. We'll lower this chord by pushing those three buttons, and if C is going to be too high, let's drop it down to an A chord, for instance. So push the three buttons, and a C chord sounds. Now push an A. And we will find now that C, when we push it, will sound A. It's no longer a C, but the whole omnichord has been dropped 1.5 tones in order to fit our voice. Now we can go along and play the chords just as previously written in the song that was too high for us, and the chords will sound down to your voice range, about 1.5 tones lower. When you come to the end of the song, simply push the three triangular buttons again and push the C chord. And that brings the omnichord right back into the correct pitch where it's supposed to be for the next song. So you see, you have at your fingertips the ability to automatically transpose into any key. Again, why don't you stop your recorder here and try this with your own Omnichord? You have now acquired the ability to accompany yourself with the Omnichord. And all that you need now is practice and experiment for yourself with the chords, the rhythms, the strum plate, and all the other features your new Omnichord has in store for you. But there's still one other way to play the instrument. This we haven't talked about yet. But it's the way to use the chord memory interface. The chord memory interface allows one to actually program the chords to any song right into the Omnichord's memory. Remember, it is a music computer. We can then play these chords back with the touch of the playback enter button in the chord memory interface section. Or if you wish, we can play these chords back with a foot switch that we can plug right into the Omnichord. When we play back the chords, we still have the strum plate to play. But in addition, in this mode, the computer will automatically change the dark gray notes in the seventh and minor chord rows to a keyboard. So we can play melodies on the keyboard, change the chords with the playback enter button or the foot switch, add embellishments with the strum plate, and still have the rhythm section as a background. To begin with, let's see how we can put chords into the Omnichord's memory. We'll start by turning on the red button in the chord memory section. Now, if there are chords already in memory, the Omnichord will hum like this is doing. These chords can be cleared from memory by pushing the three buttons with the large C on them. This is A minor, E minor, and B minor, pushing them simultaneously like this. We have just cleared the computer's memory, and we're now ready to put some chords back into its memory. Let's start by making sure your playback record button is in the down position. Now push the C major chord, and it will sound like this. Now if we push the enter button, we'll put it into memory, like this. Next, push a G7 chord. And again, push that memory or playback enter button, we'll enter it right into the memory. Now push a C chord again, and push the enter button, and another G7, and push the enter button, and we now have these four chords into the computer's memory. This is enough to get us started. Now to play these chords back, we simply put the playback record button in that same section in the up or playback position. Next, we set a rhythm in the rhythm section immediately above. For our four chords, let's put on a country beat by leaving the blue button in the top or up position and pushing the country beat down. We'll set our tempo at about 12 o'clock. Now, to start playing our first chord or C chord, we'll simply push that playback enter button once more and release it immediately like this. We can eliminate the chord sound by pushing our chord memory down, our chord only down, and we have just the beats and our first C chord. Now to change chords, we just touch that playback button again, or playback enter button. And we just change to a G7. We can strum our strum plate. We can go back to a C by pushing that playback enter button, and there's our C again. And another time, push it again, and we're back to a G7. So every time we push that button, we change to the next chord we had entered into memory. We have now used our four chords, so let's hit our repeat button down in the chord memory interface and have them all over again. Thus, we can have our four chords back to us because they have been in memory. Now, let's play a song with these chords. We mentioned that before, that when we're in this mode, in a playback mode, that the dark gray buttons in the main body of the instrument have changed from seventh chords, and the dark gray ones in the minor section from the minor chords, to a keyboard. The first one starting with a C and going on up the scale. C, D, E, F, G, A, B, C. Now, we can raise that. If you look up at the B flat button chord, it has an arrow that points up. If we push that arrow, we've now raised that whole keyboard an octave. Try it again. C, D, E, F, G, A, B, C, the same notes. We can push the down arrow in the E flat major chord and drop it right back down again. So we can actually raise or lower our keyboard a whole octave. Now, we have our beats, we have our rhythms, we can play a simple melody on our keyboard, and we can throw in any embellishments on our strum plate. The four chords we've entered into the computer's memory are the first four chords found in the song Do Re Mi from The Sound of Music. This music is found on page 17 in your Omnichord System 2 operations manual. Now, when we play them back with a melody, it will sound like this. Now, those are our first four chords plus the melody that goes with them. We can repeat them. And this time when we play through, we'll just add a few embellishments with a strum plate. You play your melodies on your keyboard. Why don't you stop your recorder right here and first try your melody with the four chords we've just described. And when you've mastered these, why don't you try entering all the chords in that song Do Re Mi found on page 17 right into your memory, and then practice playing the whole song as found in your operation manual. Congratulations again. You're well on your way now to mastering the Omnichord. But like any other musical instrument, the more you practice, the more proficient and professional you will become, and the more happiness you will derive from your Omnichord System 2 from Suzuki. On the road again. Just can't wait to get on that road again. The life I love is making music with my friends, and I can't wait to get on that road again.